Sometimes, if you're trying to get pregnant and you've been working as a couple on this and you're timing everything very well and you're not getting pregnant, you might be thinking, am I ovulating even though I'm having periods? Well, I'm going to answer that question for you today. I'm Dr. Perkins. I'm a board-certified OBGYN, and on my channel here, we talk about this and much more. Let's dive on in. Today, we will first talk about the menstrual cycle and kind of talk about the hormones and what happens to lead to periods. So let's start here. Firstly, the average menstrual cycle length is about 28 days. Your menstrual cycle begins at the first day of your period. On a 28-day cycle, right around 14 days is when ovulation would normally occur. During the first half of your menstrual cycle, estrogen is the more dominant hormone. Estrogen continues to be a part of your cycle, just in a lower amount for the second half of your cycle. Progesterone is the next hormone that plays a really big part in this process. In the first half of the cycle, estrogens are more low, and during the second half of your cycle, progesterones rise. With this, your period starts on day one. Oftentimes, your period would end by day seven. Ovulation occurs by day 14. And then the uterus continues to build up thickness, preparing for pregnancy. But once that egg dies, a signal is sent to your uterus telling it to prepare to bleed. That signal is being released in your system all the way until the end of your cycle, until a period starts again. Now, let's switch to take a look at what happens inside of your uterus. So I'm going to draw my version of what a uterus looks like. That's my ugly looking uterus for you. But here, the uterus is attached to two fallopian tubes. This is where pregnancy occurs. Eggs are released from the ovaries, of which you have two of them. Once that egg is released, the egg goes inside of the fallopian tube. If sperm is available, sperm comes through the cervix, through the uterus, and travels over to meet the egg right there. If sperm is not present and the egg dies, the uterus will then proceed to having a period. For this entire system to work, there are several different things that needs to be in place. The first thing, your ovaries must produce eggs, mature them to a point where they ovulate and they're released. If there are any problems at this point where your eggs are not being matured, they're not being released, you may have endometriosis, you may have PCOS, you may have other hormonal imbalances like thyroid disease. If any of these things are present in your system, your ovaries will not work. They will not produce the eggs that are needed. Problem number two may be right here in your fallopian tube. In your fallopian tube, you may have a blockage. That blockage can be anywhere. You can have a blockage inside of your fallopian tube, and with this blockage, an egg cannot pass through as it should, as well as sperm is not able to pass through to get to the egg. Any of these problems here may lead to infertility. Next, you may have a problem with the uterus. The uterus is one of the larger organs inside of your pelvis, and it plays a really important role. Actually, two important roles. One, periods, and two, pregnancy. If your uterus is being affected by anything inside of it, like a fibroid, a polyp, thickened tissue, cancer, anything present in this area, including an IUD, this will make pregnancy very difficult to happen. The bottom part of your uterus, this portion here, is called the cervix. The cervix is very small and has a tiny canal inside of it, tiny enough for sperm to pass through, as well as period blood to kind of pass through the opposite direction. But this opening here is very important in order for sperm to enter inside of the uterus to get on the way to the fallopian tube to cause pregnancy to happen. If there are any blockages to your cervix, then sperm won't be able to pass through, even if periods are able to pass through. Hopefully that makes sense. Periods go out, sperm goes in. But some blockages may specifically block sperm from passing through. Some of those reasons why that might be happening is because you've had previous surgery to the lower portion of your cervix. This may include having a LEAP because of HPV. This may be a cold knife cone, again, because of HPV. This may be due to having problems with bleeding that required having a biopsy off the uterus. And I'll explain why that might be. Firstly, in order for us to do a biopsy off the uterus, we need to dilate the cervix. Dilation means opening up. We need to open the cervix, stretch it open, so that we can pass instruments through to be able to get to the uterus and do sampling or biopsying. In some people, when we dilate the cervix, it creates scar tissue inside of the cervix that can lead to blockages. With that may prevent sperm from being able to pass through. By the way, if you're enjoying our conversation today and how much you've learned, please do subscribe. And if you'd like to know when our videos are new on this channel, go ahead and hit that bell so you will be notified. The fifth cause of infertility in females may be endometriosis. With this disease, tissue that is normally supposed to be on the inside of the uterus may also now be present in the body elsewhere. So outside of the uterus, by the ovaries, by the fallopian tube, inside where you have bowels and you have your bladder and everything, this tissue is everywhere. And with that tissue may cause a lot of scarring, inflammation, and problems inside, including causing blockages in your fallopian tube. Now, I completely skipped number four, so let's go back to reason number four. Primary ovarian insufficiency. With this disease, what happens is that the ovary is no longer producing enough eggs. This may mean that you've run out or depleted the amount of your eggs that you were born with. This may mean that your total egg count has now been reduced due to medications that you're taking or treatments that you're receiving. This happens before the point of natural menopause, which on average happens at the age of 51. Reason number six for having female infertility may be having pelvic scarring, or what we call adhesions. This means that inside of your body, because of prior surgery or prior infections, you may have scar tissue that is preventing your organs from functioning the way they should. Sometimes it may lead to blockages in the fallopian tube. Sometimes it may lead to you having physically new tissue being formed in between your organs, preventing you from getting pregnant. Knowing your surgical history is very important in understanding what your risk factors may be due to pelvic adhesions. Lastly, I've mentioned this a few times, but cancer may be the cause of infertility in the female system. And that cancer could be not in and of itself, but the treatment that you get for cancer. That could be cancer due to the reproductive system, your ovaries, fallopian tubes, uterus, vagina, cervix, vulva, or it could be cancers of the breast or any other system in your body. So as we're talking about infertility today, know that you may have a problem in any of these areas and still have periods. Having periods does not necessarily mean that you are fertile. It just means that you've produced an egg, the egg dies, and it tells your uterus to have a period. As far as the egg traveling through your system and being able to get to the point of meeting sperm, that may not happen. And these are some of the reasons why that may be. I have a free ebook that I'd like to offer you today that will help your body to be better, to be more balanced, and get your hormones in check. To do that, click the link below and visit my website for more information. It's been a pleasure talking to you today about female infertility and reasons why you may be infertile while having periods. I hope you enjoyed our conversation. I'm Dr. Perkins, a board-certified OBGYN, and I'd love to see you next time. Thank you.